next speaker is Enrique Mendoina. He's from Telefonica M2M, Telefonica Digital, and he is responsible for the alliances and new business at Telefonica M2M. Please, would you give a warm welcome to Enrique? Thank
you. So thank you very much indeed for this great opportunity to share with you our views, our strategy. My presentation is a little bit different from the previous ones, in the sense that I'm going to talk about strategy, what we are doing, and especially how we intend to cooperate with other actors or players within the machine-to-machine value chain in order to try to develop this business. So this is the outline of topics I want to share with you today. First of all, I want to give a brief overview about the machine-to-machine market dynamics in terms of barriers and drivers. And the reason for that is that we think these are quite important elements we have to take into account whenever we want to devise or to conceive a strategy. And that's precisely what we are doing within Telefonica, taking into account those market drivers, the technology, the things that are trying to push or hindering the development of this market. We want to have several ideas on how to go further with this. And finally, I will give specific details on one of element of this strategy, that is the cooperation, the relationship between the different telecom operators and between the different operators and other players of the machine-to-machine value chain. How we are tackling this, how we are managing this, and what's the final objective of this scope. So what, talking about drivers that somehow are boosting the development of this business, I think probably these facts are very well known for you, and everybody would agree. First of all, I would like to stress the decline of prices. That's something that is happening, everybody knows. And when I'm talking about here, about declining prices, I'm talking about both network fees, but also in terms of the other elements needed for building a complete solution. That means modules, devices, and so on and so forth. Another important factor here is the regulation requirements. Fortunately, in some cases, the governments are favoring several policies whose implementation could be very easily made by means of machine-to-machine solutions. And smart metering is the most clear example of that. Besides, one thing that all the telecom operators are doing is a great effort in the expanding the coverage of our networks for 2G, 3G, and even beyond. And at least in our opinion, and that's something that we are checking with our telecom operators, the machine-to-machine market or business is seen as one of the biggest opportunities for the future growth of the different telecom operators. And clearly, probably today we'll have the chance to discuss what kind of applications are going to achieve that. And moreover, the convergence of the cloud and machine-to-machine worlds are also somehow making simple to launch and faster to build the different solutions that we intend to put in the market. And this convergence is also trying, is also diminishing the risk that the customers are having as well. And one very good example of that is the organization of Telefonica. Now Telefonica has decided to bring together the units of cloud and machine-to-machine. We are under the same head, and our aim is obviously to achieve synergies of trying to provide convergence services to our customers. But on the contrary, there are still some barriers that are somehow hindering the development of this very complex market. One of them could be the lack of scalability. Quite often we found that the solutions that we develop are specifically developed for a vertical market, for a specific technology, or even for a wireless network. It's rather difficult to find a real solution that goes across different verticals, different markets, or it's even technology agnostics. And similar things is happening with the standard. There is a lack of a standard in terms of applications and machine-to-machine interfaces and so on and so forth. So that and besides, there is no single, let's say, important standardization body dealing with these kind of things. And that obviously adds complexity to the different actors who somehow find that the interoperability of their solution is not really guaranteed. And another element is the lack of proven results. We often find several very good applications, but these applications have no real or no solid business case behind. Or if that model exists, is rather weak because the return of investment you have to make to deploy is long-term due. And maybe the same reasoning could be applied to in respect to the lack of big players. We receive some criticisms from our customers because they say, well, yes, this is a very good solution, but it's just a trial, it's just something that you are testing on the lab, but there is no massive deployment of this, so how are you sure that this is broken, is working properly if you deploy massively this solution? And the same is more or less, we do not have a very good argument to sell this if we receive this kind of criticism for our customers. But that's something that is changing quite a lot, and we have seen very good examples here from my previous speakers as they are deploying that, and we in Telefonica are doing the same thing. So that means that in the near future there will be massive deployments of a lot of different applications all over the world that will be working perfectly, so that's a very good sales argument to our customers. Another important restriction is the intrinsic complexity of the value chains. Whenever we want to work with different partners, we found that we have to handle it. It's complex. There are a lot of different elements, players within the value chain, and that's costly. So that's something we have to somehow improve. So if we want to succeed in this very complex market, we have to take into account some lessons learned. I would say that we should somehow focus on verticals. That means that this is not a real unified, unique market. There are a lot of different markets, and we have to work in order to cover their specificities and so on and so forth. Obviously, we should intend to try it to extract synergies or commonalities from all these solutions, but sometimes it is not that easy. The execution of this strategy could be done by means of different approaches, depending on the approaches you take, your position will be completely different, and that's important in terms of the innovation you take, if you are focused on verticals or you just provide connectivity, depending on the vertical, the vertical value-added services you choose to be deployed, and so on and so forth. So this is a very, let's say, complex in terms of a strategy market, and different approaches could be taken. And the other important issue is the collaboration, as I said before, and that's more or less what I'm to give here, that message that is quite important to collaborate with our players, because well, the lack of standardization is somehow hindering the development, and we should do an effort to collaborate among us to try to do this. So the lesson learned here is that standardization is of the utmost importance. And innovation is also crucial to bet on the innovation, and the innovation could be done in several ways. You could bet on platforms, you could bet on verticals, you could bet on team developments, and so on and so forth. All of them are quite important in such a way. And one important issue is try to create an ecosystem around you that helps you to deploy this kind of services. And that's something that I will give you details later, so here just to stress the importance of that element. So taking into account all these, let's say, lessons learned that we have achieved, and also thinking that machine-to-machine is one of the most important opportunities for telecom operators in the future, we have tried to devise a strategy. And I would say that the strategy in this case for us has twofold. One thing that we are going to do, or at least we are just doing, is the provision of managed connectivity by means of a horizontal platform. And that's quite important. Obviously, all the telecom operators are doing the same, and I've heard my previous colleague that Vodafone is doing the same, but it's clear that there is no great difference in the approaches we are everybody taking. And another important point is that we intend to provide services, vertical services, value-added services in a lot of different sectors. And this is a great difference in respect to our operators who, at the end, are just going to give, let's say, connectivity. But, well, we still think that we should go into the market of vertical value-added services because the money is there, because the cost of the connectivity is declining, so we should try to get that opportunity. And the obvious thing is, the obvious questions here is which are these services, which is the most promising markets in which we could bet. And the answer is here. This is for methodological reasons and organizational reasons why how we are organize the different services. Clearly, there is another ways to organize that, but everybody could agree that more or less all the applications in this market will be under the umbrella of these different items. Transport is quite important, and in our case, within this area is where we have launched the first services, solution for both the aftermarket and the OEM needs of transport. Smart city, we have a very important bet on smart city. Even we still think that it should be further developed, and this is just a concept, but we think that there are a lot of different very good promising services to be developed. Energy, we have my previous colleagues have been talking about that, and it's a very huge opportunity, the intelligent management of the energy in order to save resources, in order to save energy, in order to save money. Industry, under the umbrella of industry, for us, we include a lot of different applications. These are rather specific in many cases. It could be said that these are, in some cases, niche verticals, but we still think that we could tackle this market. And obviously, consumer electronics, the control, the connectivity of every devices that we have for entertainment, and so on and so forth. So, as I said before, one thing I want to stress here is the intention of cooperating between the different elements of the value chains and between the different telecom operators. And that's precisely what we are doing. We are promoting the creation of an open alliance between the operators to tackle this market. And the reason for that is that, well, there are a lot of different reasons, but one of them is that we need worldwide coverage, because most of our customers will come with requirements to be served all over the world. And at the end, I could happily announce that we have achieved to bring on board to this alliance to some important players in the world. Some of them is China Unicom, with which we have a strategic alliance in China, obviously. And another is Avea, a Turkish operator, a mobile Turkish operator, with which we are working very hard at this point of time. But there is obviously the intention to further go with this open alliance, and we are in negotiation with other operators to have them on board. And what's the mission, the objective of this alliance is we are trying to agree. Well, the main aim obviously is to achieve in synergies, to reducing cost, to gain a better footprint. We need a global coverage and roaming capabilities. And at the end, what do we intend to have is seamless unique value proposition to be served to serve our clients worldwide. Another thing we are doing at this point of time is trying to create an ecosystem of other partners around us. And when I'm talking here about other partners, our other partners within the machine-to-machine value chains. Examples are obviously chip manufacturers, module vendors, solution providers, and so on and so forth. And the reason for that is that this value chain is very fragmented. It's very difficult to build a complete solution trying to get all the different pieces of the puzzle, and we need somehow to structure this collaboration by means of program, by means of very well-defined collaborations, and so on and so forth. At the end, that's the idea, just to have the best-in-class players working with us to develop jointly this machine-to-machine market. And obviously, we intend to have very good services to shorten the time to market of those services, and so on and so forth. So, as a conclusion, I will say that our customers are asking us for specific machine-to-machine transnational services. That means that we have offered the services. Well, sometimes the services should be offered locally, but in most of the cases, at least these first, let's say, larger bids, most of our customers are requesting us to have global coverage, to have a unique solution, to be served all over the world in the same way, and so on and so forth. This one is important requirement for the machine-to-machine market. Well, in order to do that, what we want to do is to have alliances with a lot of different telecom operators all over the world to try to achieve this goal of serving our service worldwide with the same unique value proposition. These alliances obviously bring us another benefits, other benefits such as reducing cost. We have better, let's say, roaming capabilities. We could guarantee the quality of the services whenever some people, our customers, are crossing borders, and so on and so forth. So at the end, we need to have a universal, seamless solution for this kind of, let's say, global customers. In the same way, Partnerships are critical because this is a very complex value chain. We have to reduce the cost of managing this partner, and so we need to somehow to have a very good structure, very good programs, very good procedures to incorporate those partners to our ecosystems whenever we want to build a complete solution taking parts of one partner, other, and whatever. So at the end, in my end messages is that Telefonica is fully committed with this process of promoting the global alliances with other telecom operators, and we are also engaged and created these partnerships with some other players of the value chain in order to develop this market, because this market is quite complex, and we are pretty sure that that's something we are not going to do alone. That's the reason why I need some other important players. And that's all from my side. Thank you very much indeed, and if you have further questions on this, I will be very pleased to answer them.
Any questions for Enrique, please? Please, could you introduce yourself and your company as well?
Good morning. My name is Donald Donovan. I'm from Intel. So many thanks for the talk. I have one question.
Enrique is over here. Over here, Enrique. Enrique, this way.
Oh, all right. It's because of the light there. I cannot see you.
No problem. One question. So the actions you take with regard to consolidation or bringing together in the ecosystem, I can see this would be the backbone to, say, improving the value services or the value service part of the business that you do.
Yeah.
I was wondering, could you put that in context? So today, if you look at, say, traditional business over connectivity versus value-added services, how would you see the growth aspect of that, say, over the next 5 years?
Well, I think that there will be a consolidation. That means that at this point of time, most of the telecom operators are doing, obviously, managed connectivity, and that's our business. That's the new business more adjacent to our traditional business. That is the reason why, obviously, we are starting with that. But at this point of time, we see that the costs are declining, so we need to go further and to provide other kind of services. But as this is a very heterogeneous world, we don't know, we don't have the skills to go to every sector. So we have to go there to get the right partner, because they have the skills, they know the business, and then we create somehow an alliance with them, a partnership with them, and go to the market. As soon as we are, let's say, learning how these different sectors work, probably in the future we'll develop, deploy, and provide customer care by our own. But at this first stage, we prefer to go with people who has a very good knowledge of that market. But that's something that we are doing in a very flexible way. That means that we are open to receive proposals, people that have very good solutions. We work with them to provide the service jointly or wherever. So I would say that here we are quite flexible in doing any kind of things. What we intend to do at the end is just to develop this market, and if it's possible to do it alone, perfectly. If we need to have a partner, perfectly. If we have to learn the lessons from the people who has modules, perfectly. We are going to work together with them. So we are perfectly open to work with a lot of different players within the machine-to-machine value chain.
Thank you, Eric. Any more questions? Please, could you introduce yourself and your
question? Yes, this is Dündar Özdemir from Turkcell, Turkey. My question is about, first of all, I want to thank you for your good presentation. My question is about your strategic alliances with other operators. Mm-hmm. For example, Avaya or China Mobile. Are you using the single M2M SIM card of Telefonica in Turkey, or are you using the SIM cards of Avaya or China Mobile?
It depends on the cases. services, but at the end what we intend to do is to have embedded SIMs with the capability to transfer subscription from one operator to another at the end. That's something that is being done in the, within the GSMA, and we expect to have that as the final solution. At this point of time, what we are doing is testing that, and whenever we had, let's say, a customer there, depending on the regulations, the local regulations, depending on the number of subscription we have, we follow one or different approach. It depends. For instance, when it's a very, let's say, tiny number of subscription, is not worth to do in another way, just a roaming. It's, you do it by roaming, there is no problem at all. But depending on some countries, the permanent roaming is not allowed or is not well, let's say, seen or whatever. So it depends on the situation. But at the end, what we intend to have is a very powerful tool to change the subscription between different operators. And that's the final goal.
Thank you very much, Enrique. Just one more question. Just one here at the back, please.
Okay. Sheridan Nye from Informa Telecoms and Media. I'm over here.
Okay.
I just wondered, do you see a time where Telefonica could be making acquisitions around some of these vertical areas of vertical specialization?
Well, we are working very hard in having a lot of different products in that sense. Obviously, we have our priority. We have started with the fleet management. Probably we'll have solutions for insurance telematics soon. We think that smart meeting will be another very important service that could be provided in the future. Depending on geographies, some services are more or less promising. So there is no single answer to that, but we are working very hard in having solutions for all these services that I have mentioned before.
Thank you very much, Enrique. Just one question at the front.
Yeah, this is Jürgen Scheller from Intel. One question about the air interfaces. Could you give us a feeling how important the different air interfaces like GPRS, 3G or LTE are for your M2M strategy?
At this point of time, most of our, obviously, because the data are quite small in most of the applications, we are using 2G. In some cases, we are thinking of migrating clearly to 3G, and LTE will come later. And we are starting our deployment of LTE in some of the countries where we operate. The first one has been in some areas, Germany. Spain will come later, and other countries will come later. And it's a balance. It's not very easy because sometimes we need to provide, let's say, connectivity to a customer for a long time, and we somehow cannot guarantee that all the G's will be there whenever they want to continue with their services. So even in some cases, the price of the modules of having the solution with the 3G is higher. Maybe it's better doing it in that way. But we are assessing this balance between the different generations, the cost of modules, whenever we want to deploy massively our SIM cards all over the world. That's something we are doing, but obviously at the end we'll be migrating towards more capabilities.
Thank you. Just one final question at the back, please.
Mohammed Sadiq from Giza Systems Integrator in Saudi, Qatar, and Egypt. I don't see in the verticals that you proposed anything about the health, the mHealth. Are you looking at these verticals as well?
Yes. You are perfectly right. But maybe my mistake here is that, in fact, for organizational reasons, within Telefonica Digital, which is the recently created company for Telefonica to tackle with the new markets, the emerging services, and so on and so forth, within that Telefonica Digital, we have a specific unit devoted to deploy and develop solutions for health. And there's a reason why is not appearing here, because we see the machine-to-machine as an enabler of that will somehow facilitate the deployment of this kind of services, but you are sure, pretty sure, that my colleagues in that unit will be dealing with that. Okay. Sorry for that. It's just that I was thinking on my own organization.
Thank you very much, Enrique. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all time we have for Q&A for Enrique. Please give me a warm welcome and a round of applause for Enrique there. We now have time for our morning tea break, so please join us back at about 10:45. Thank you very much. Stop.